हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, स्टैंडर्ड 8 सॉरी इन मैथ्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सम रिविजन्स ऑफ चैप्टर 1 एंड देन आफ्टर दैट चैप्टर 2, बिकॉज देर विल बी अ यूनिट टेस्ट एट द एंड ऑफ दिस मंथ। सो आई वॉन्ट that you should revise everything, otherwise maybe you forgot. So for the practice we are going to do some revisions. First, chapter 1, rational numbers. We are doing some blanks today. Number 1, the collection of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ... are known as blank numbers. We know that they are the numbers which are the natural numbers. So answer is natural numbers. Second, the collection of numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are known as so when we add 0 along with the natural numbers, they become whole numbers. So answer is whole numbers. Third one, dash numbers are also known as counting numbers. Counting numbers, which number we use for counting? We start from 1, so 1, 2, 3, 4 with those same thing, means natural numbers. So natural numbers are also known as counting numbers. Blank is a whole number, but not a natural number. We know that whole numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, up to this, in which only 0 is such that it is only a whole number but not a natural number, because 1, 2, 3 up to all are the natural numbers also. So only 0 is such a number which is a whole number but not a natural number. Number 5, there are blank rational numbers. Rational numbers between -1 and 2. Now here there is a chance of making mistake in a hurry. Generally what we count, -1 and 2. So on the number line, -1, then 0, then 1 and 2. So between -1 and 2, there are two numbers, 0 and 1. But they are the whole numbers. What is written here? Rational numbers. We know that between any two numbers, there are infinitely many or uncountable rational numbers. So answer will be uncountable. Not the only two rational numbers, because any two numbers, if you take between them, there are so many, means uncountable rational numbers are there. If it was whole number or integers, then you could write down only two, but when the rational numbers are there, we know that there are only not countable but so many uncountable rational numbers between them. Number 6, to represent one integer 2 upon 5 on a number line, we should make blank equal parts between 1 and 2. So when we represent the rational numbers on number line, we have to make equal parts according to the denominator. So what is the denominator here? 5. So we should make how many? 5 equal parts between 1 and 2. So the answer is 5. Number 7. The additive inverse of minus 3 upon 4 is blank. So now it is additive inverse. So additive inverse means just we have to change the sign, plus to minus or minus to plus. So answer is 3 upon 4 itself. Just change the sign. But if the multiplicative inverse of the same number is there, is blank. So we know that multiplicative inverse, we have to change the places of numerator and denominator. So the number in the denominator will go into the numerator, and the number which is in the numerator will go to the denominator. So it can be, sign will be same, minus 4 upon 3. Or as it is the improper fraction, you can convert them into mixed number also. So minus 4 by 3, so 4 by 3 can be written as 3 1 ja 3, integer 1 upon 3. So you can write down either of this number answer. You can write down either minus 4 by 3 or minus 1 integer 1 by 3, because it can be written as the improper fraction also, and it can be written in the form of mixed number also. Now number 9. The reciprocal of dash does not exist. We know that all the numbers have reciprocals except the one number, and that number is 0, because division by 0 is not possible. 1 upon 0 we cannot write down. So 0, so you can write down that 0, or you can write down in the words 0. Then number 10, reciprocal of additive inverse of 1 is blank. So first we have to find the reciprocal of additive inverse of 1. So what is additive inverse of 1? Minus 1. Reciprocal minus 1 is minus 1 itself. because 1 and minus 1 are such numbers whose reciprocals are the same number. So here your answer is minus 1. Now the 11, sum of 2 opposite numbers is blank. The other name of opposite numbers, you know that it is additive inverse also. So when we add two additive inverse or two opposite numbers, the answer is 0. For example, 5 and minus 5, 8 and minus 8, minus 3 by 2 and plus 3 by 2, etc. So sum of two opposite numbers is always 0. Number 12. Product of a number and its reciprocal is blank. And the other name of reciprocal is multiplicative inverse. So when we take a number and its multiplicative inverse, when we multiply them, answer becomes 1. So we know that product of two numbers which are reciprocals, the answer is always number 1. 13. Reciprocal of blank and blank is the same number. So which are the two numbers whose reciprocal is the number itself? And then are the two numbers only which are 1 and minus 1. Because reciprocal of 1 is 1 itself. Reciprocal of minus 1 is also minus 1 itself. So answer is 1 and minus 1. 14. A rational number whose denominator is five and numerator is minus 3 is blank. So here sometimes chance of making mistake, like what? Generally, what do we write down? First number given in numerator, second number in the denominator. So you will write down 5 upon minus 3, but 5 is in the denominator, minus 3 is in the numerator. So answer will be minus 3 upon 5, not minus 5 upon 3. So that is the main thing you have to remember, that denominator should be in the down, numerator will be on the top. 15. Blank is the multiplicative identity. Blank is the multiplicative identity for rational numbers. Multiplicative identity means if we multiply that rational number with number, the number itself comes. Means the answer does not change. What should we multiply 3 by 5 to get 3 by 5 only? That is 1. So 1 is the multiplicative identity for rational number. Then 16th. Dash is the identity for addition of rational number. Addition of rational number. So now, what should we add in a rational number to get the number itself? Obviously, nothing means zero. So, zero is the identity for addition of rational numbers. 17. The two numbers whose product is 1 are called blank of each other. So we already done that here. Product of a natural a number and its reciprocal. So they are known as reciprocal or multiplicative inverse. Whatever you write down is the same answer. So here we can write down reciprocal. They are known as reciprocal of each other. Or you can write down multiplicative inverse of each other. Then blank number 18. Three upon eleven plus blank is equal to zero. We know that when can be the sum will be zero? When it is the additive inverse. So what is the additive inverse of 3 upon 11? That is minus 3 upon 11. So 3 upon 11 plus minus 3 upon 11 is equal to 0. Then minus 4 upon 5 multiplied by blank is 1. So product of two reciprocals is 1. So what is the reciprocal of minus 4 upon 5? It is minus 5 upon 4. So it is minus 5 upon 4. And number 20. The multiplicative inverse of 1 integer 2 upon 8 is blank. Now sometimes when we have to write down multiplicative inverse, students are making mistakes. They only switch over the 8 up and 2. Right? So they will write down 1 integer 8 upon 2, but it is not like that. First we have to convert it into from mixed number to improper fraction, and then we have to find the reciprocal. So now this number is 8 plus 2 10. 8 plus 2 10. And then the multiplicative inverse 10 upon 8, so its inverse will be 8 upon 10. 1 integer 2 upon 8, so 8 plus 2 10 upon 8. So we have the reciprocal means multiplicative inverse will be 10 upon 8 is 8 upon 10. So now here we are going to finish the session. Any confusion, please write down in the comment section and do the revision, and it will be followed by the PDF file. Write down in your notebook. Thank you very much.